us today. I want to thank you for your courage, for helping us to do our job to protect the American people. I want to start today by restating what I said at a hearing February 26th with Secretary Azar, right here, right at that table. The key to a public health crisis is trust and credibility. On that day, I urged Secretary Azar to provide clear, credible updates from this administration to the American public. However, your whistleblower complaint and testimony today unveil unheeded warnings about personal protective equipment, testing supplies, and vaccine supplies. Over the past several months, I have held countless conversations with doctors and nurses and hospitals and community health centers and our Republican governor and every other person in New Hampshire trying to get access to personal protective equipment to protect our frontline workers, to protect our grocery clerks. We've been trying to get testing supplies, and we were told that because we were not a hotspot, we were on our own. And we literally had to turn to entrepreneurs, thank God they exist, and thank you to them for flying to China and bringing us the equipment we need that should and could have been distributed had we planned ahead. These conversations have informed my roadmap to recovery on how to safely reopen our economy. And key to those efforts is adequate testing, contact tracing, supported isolation, and vaccine development, your specialty. So I want to focus on your role as Director of BARDA in vaccine development and distribution. On page 28 and 29 of your addendum to your complaint, it states that BARDA estimated that between 650 million and 850 million needles and syringes would be needed for a vaccine to be administered here in the United States, for everyone to be safe. Your team at BARDA also estimates it could take up to 2 years to manufacture these vaccine delivery supplies. To your knowledge, Dr. Bright, at this time, has the administration placed any orders to prepare for how a vaccine will be delivered when one becomes available to every American?
I learned that they placed an order, the first order for needles and syringes on May 1st, and another order was placed today.
And were the amounts adequate?
I believe that it's for 320 million needles and syringes.
And could you please describe the situation if every American does not have access to the vaccine due to a supply shortage?
That situation would be catastrophic, honestly. The decisions have not been made yet, who to vaccinate first, how to identify those individuals, and how to stretch those limited supplies appropriately. And it's important to remember that it's not just the United States. So there's limited supplies. When I said it would take 2 to 2.5 years to make those, that was assuming there wouldn't be global competition for those limited supplies. Those are not made in the United States, some of them, so.
Does a lack of preparation in vaccine supplies make us more vulnerable to future spikes in COVID-19?
Absolutely.
And do we have enough supplies to distribute both the flu vaccine next winter as well as the coronavirus vaccine?
It's going to be extremely challenging.
Do we know yet of the interactions of the full-fledged flu season in combination with COVID-19?
We haven't seen that yet. Luckily, in this spring, flu was winding down when COVID-19 was emerging.
And without adequate supplies to vaccinate all Americans for COVID-19, does this slow down the goal of fully reopening our economy and getting back to the normal that every American wants?
It certainly brings caution and a significant consideration that must be taken into consideration before reopening. We need to make sure that not only the guidelines for reopening are clear to each individual, and each individual follows those guidelines, otherwise it puts us all at risk.
So can I ask you a question? And I know you're not political, and certainly we are all trying not to be political. In fact, I'm very proud in our state that our delegation and our governor are working so well together. But Dr. Bright, does this virus give a damn whether a patient is Republican or Democrat?
No, it doesn't. This virus just wants to infect people, and unfortunately a lot of those people get really sick and many of them die.
Thank you. I'm so grateful, not just for your knowledge, for your humility, and for your service to our country. Thank you, and I yield back.
Thank you.
Gentlewoman yields back.